What's up guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all good. So in today's video, I am currently half naked in my bathroom, and for good reason, because today I'm gonna be sharing with you guys my updated tanning routine. I feel like I've nailed it. I feel like that's a big statement to make, but I really do feel like I've nailed my tanning routine recently. A lot of these products and tips and tricks I've used for years, and a lot of the products are actually by UTan, who have very kindly sponsored today's video. But if you guys have watched my channel for a while, you'll know that I have loved so many of their tanning products for so long. The face mist is literally my ride or die. So yeah, I've got some products that I've been using for years, some products that I've tried out over the past month or so. I'm really liking them. And I think you will too, because honestly, I feel like my tanning routine, this is like the most solid tanning routine I've ever had. No patchiness, no orange, no like patchy hands or anything like that. So if you guys wanna check out anything from UTan, as always, all the links, any codes that I have will be down below. Scroll down a little bit, click the read more button in the description. You'll see everything there. You're welcome. But anyway, now that's all out of the way, let's get our tan on, quite literally. Let's go. Step one. Get your hair out your face. All right, so the first thing I want to talk about very briefly is prep. I feel like prep is the most important part for any good tan, because if your skin's dry, I'll go through a bunch of other things in a second, but if your skin's not 100%, your tan ain't gonna look 100%. So there's a few things that I like to do when I'm prepping my tan. The first thing, and I swear by this, is actually a brand new one that I had to rush to Superdrug to pick up, because I was like, okay, I'm gonna need this. Like, this is honestly gonna be your best friend when it comes to removing tan. Obviously, I haven't got any tan at the moment, but honestly, this stuff, you put it on, just literally pump it into your hands, apply it all over your body. So you can leave it on for 5 minutes if you wanna get rid of a 3-day-old tan, 10 minutes if you have a little bit more of a self-tan buildup, and then if you want a full-on detox, which I usually do once a week anyway, leave it on for like 15 to 30 minutes. Usually, I find that 15 minutes is fine for me. And yeah, you just put it on with your hands, leave it to work its magic for however long, and then you just scrub it off. You can either use like an exfoliating mitt, you can use a flannel. It will literally just come off, and you just give your skin a little scrub, and you'll just be like, you'll just watch all of your tan just go down the drain. Like, goodbye, bye, have fun down there. But yeah, this is an absolute must for me. I have tried to get rid of fake tan before in the past, just by scrubbing it, exfoliating, whatever. This just makes everything so much easier. It smells good as well. Like, I've tried out other products like this before, and they sting your skin, and they don't smell too good. It almost feels like you're putting bleach on your skin. Don't do that. But this is probably the best one that I've tried. Then, as you can see, I've got a little dry brush here. I don't tend to exfoliate too much with anything overly gritty. I will just use a dry brush. So like, just after my shower or something, I'll just give myself a nice little brush. I do this anyway, once a week, usually, regardless of whether I'm wearing fake tan or not, just because I find it just gets rid of any dead skin, and it's very minimal effort, which is great for me. So, I mean, I'm not gonna show you all my full body, but I do just give myself a little brush. So the areas that I mostly focus on, to be honest, is my elbows, usually a little bit around my wrists. I find that's where I can, if I ever do, I can get a little bit more of like a fake tan build up there. So I just make sure that any dry skin is gone from there. I'll usually even go over my hands a bit too. Give my knees a little scrub, and then I'll just go around my ankles as well, and just over any dry patches. One thing I never do before I tan as well is shave. I've had so many people that have said, you know, how do I get rid of like the little dots that you can get sometimes when you put tan on? And it's because you've probably shaved beforehand. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't have to shave too often at all now because I have been doing laser. But if I've got like a little bit of fuzz on my legs or something, or like under my arms, I will just leave it. Don't worry about it, shave it after. And that is probably the most foolproof way to make sure that you don't have any little like brown spots or anything in your hair follicles, because that's kind of like what it is. You know, if you're shaving your skin, the tan is then gonna go into those hair follicles or into your pores, and it can just make it not look as flawless. So that's probably one of my main tips that you should like put in your little brain. Maybe big brain. I'm not insinuating you have little brains. I have a little brain. Put it in your big brain. And yeah, just shave after. Or not at all. Do whatever the hell you want. Have a rage and everything and a glorious tan and hair all over your body. But if you want to stop your tan from like settling into your pores, shave after. Or shave the day before. Or even if you have to, like the morning before, try and leave the biggest gap that you can in between shaving and tanning. Or don't shave at all, because it's your body, you can do whatever you want. Shave it, don't shave it. Become a mammoth. A tanned mammoth. Next. I don't know why I present it to you like that. But another thing I always make sure to do before I tan regardless of what kind of tan it is, whether it's gradual, anything, I'll always make sure to put a little bit of moisturizer on the dry areas. So I basically focus again on my elbows. I'll rub all of this in as we go, but I'll put it on the inner part of my arm as well because I don't want it to kind of gather around there. I'll whack it on my knees. And these are just like typical places that most people tend to get dry. But I mean, if you get a dry left thigh, then just, you know your body better than anyone else. Wherever you think you've got dry skin, just put a little bit of like a thicker moisturizer on there. Just so when you do put the tan on, it'll just glide over and won't make it look crusty. I actually even like to go under my armpits with moisturizer. Obviously I haven't got any deodorant on or anything like that because that will sort of stop your tan from working as well. So far my tips are be stinky and be hairy and you'll get a flawless tan. But yeah, I just like to moisturize under my pits. And then when it comes to my feet and hands, I lag my hands and feet in hand cream. Number one, because when I'm tanning, it just means that my hands just get nice and soft. So I'm just like a little hand mask, but I lag my hands in moisturizer. And I also, I'm not gonna give you too much of like a foot show here, but I'll do the same on my feet as well and make sure that I, again, try not to fall over. I'm trying really hard right now. And just go around my ankles and all over my feet. Okay, so now we're on to actual tan. Now this is definitely something you can do or you can skip out on, but I find personally this makes my tan last for so, so long. So this is a CBD serum. And this, even on its own, especially now it's like getting a little bit warmer in the UK, I swear I've made the rookie mistake of filming this by my skylight on one of the hottest days of the year so far. So if I just start to melt into the floor, just talk amongst yourselves. But yeah, that's what the tanning water looks like. This is a brand new one. Utan very kindly sent over a bunch of new products to me because mine were very well loved. But yeah, I just give it a little shake and I've got the tanning mitt here and give it a couple of sprays and just apply that all over the body in circular motions. And what I will typically do with this, it takes around about 6 to 8 hours to develop. So what I'll usually do is I'll do this in the evening and it's really, really lightweight. Again, you can just use this on its own if you want something a little bit more natural, but it still does give you a really nice glow and it smells so good as well. So yeah, I'll apply that just all over my skin and it'll just give my tan a really nice base and it does really help to make my tan last a lot longer because you've got the layers. So like when we do my proper tan, that will last me for ages, but then as it sort of starts to break down, I'll still have this like at the base of my skin. And so it just helps to make it last longer and not go patchy. If you have the time, it kind of levels up your tan even more. And as you can see, it's a really, really lightweight mist as well. So you can literally just chuck this on, go about your day. And like I said, it smells good. Doesn't smell like biscuits. I mean, I love biscuits, but I don't want to smell like one. And yeah, obviously I would normally do this without a bikini on, but I would also normally do it without it being filmed. But I just go all over my body. It's really, really easy to apply. You don't even really need to be that precise. Just make sure you sort of give it a good blend. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it at that for a minute and then I'll just do like the full body tan off camera. We're friends, we're not that good friends. So once that's all done, what I then like to use, again, a brand new one, you will see my one, the one with Jamie's lovely face on it that I use and I have used it to death. So this one is actually the coconut. I should probably say what it is. It's the coconut tanning water. They do a few different other ones. They do a CBD one. They do the one in collaboration with Jamie. They do the original one and then they do these ones here, which are 50% darker, which I tend to prefer a little bit more. I just find it's a lot more noticeable. But if you want something that's a bit more subtle that gives you a little bit of a glow, you can always go for the original. But I find because I do fake tan quite a lot, this is really good. But yeah, this is one of those products that I was saying is my ride or die. I will use it every single evening, some mornings as well, depending on how my skin's looking. I don't need to faff around with like tan on my face and it blocking my pores. You just spray it over the top of your moisturizer. You could do it without, but I do tend to prefer using it with a moisturizer. It develops in about 4 to 6 hours. So just to get me another base going, I will spray that all over my face. And then sometimes I'll go kind of like around my neck a little bit as well. One really good hack with this that I kind of discovered by accident, to be honest, is, you know, we're like washing our hands a lot more. And even before all of this happened, I would always find that the tan on my hands would always fade a lot quicker than the rest of my body. I will literally just spray it on my hands. And again, it's not too intense. It's not going to make your hands look only like muddy or anything like that. And it's just something you can just quickly spray on. Go like around your wrist, even on your actual palms of your hand. I do literally like one spray just so again, I've got a little bit of something there. But yeah, I'll just spray that a little bit sort of on my wrists and on my hands, on my feet as well if I need to. But yeah, this is like my ride or die facial tanner. I use it every single day. So that's it for phase one. What can I tell you? I take tanning very, very seriously. So by the time this is developed, it will probably be best for me to film tomorrow. So I'm gonna go about my day and then I'll check out with you guys and I'll show you my bronze glow. Okay, see you tomorrow. All right guys, so it's now the next day. As you can see, I've got like a really nice golden glow on me. So that is the result of the water serum. And sometimes I will just leave it at that because it does give you a really nice golden glow. Like when I get a bit more of a natural tan, I'll probably use that on top to kind of just add to it a bit. But now because I want to bronze myself up a little bit more, I'm going to go in with this guy here. This is the best smelling tan I have ever come across. It smells like cherry, but it literally makes you smell like a cherry cola bottle, you know, like one of those little sweets. But yeah, this is the Turbo Self Tan Mousse. So you can use this for as long as you want, really. So it says on the side, you can use it for 1 hour for a golden glow, 2 for a sun-kissed tan, 3 hours for a golden tan, or 8+ hours for an ultra dark. At the moment, I tend to do it for around about 3 hours. Usually if I'm doing it for 8+ hours, I'll just sleep in it overnight. But at the moment, just because it is so hot and everything, I am just doing it for 3 hours and it still gives me a really, really nice tan. So I've already done the same thing that I did before in regards to like lotioning up my elbows, moisturizing my knees. One thing I didn't actually mention is normally with my tattoos as well, just because a few of them are newer, and I don't really want to get tan like caught up in the drier tattoos, I will just apply like a tattoo balm or just a sand and moisturizer over them a little bit more, just so again no tan kind of sticks to them. And again, before I put on the tanning mitt, I'm just gonna rub a load of moisturizer in my hands, go like right in between my fingers as well. But yeah, this stuff here is one of my newer products that I've been trying out. I've had this for a little while now and I am fully just obsessed with it. So I take a couple of pumps onto the mitt. It honestly just smells like sweets. And like not like fake tan with a sweet smell, it just smells like sweets. And you don't get that fake tan smell at all. Like I even saw Ollie the other day, I've just put on tan and he was like, oh, you smell nice. When does a guy ever say that your fake tan smells nice? Normally they're the first ones to be like complaining about it and saying how biscuity you smell, but this stuff just smells good. Like you tan actually, can we get a facial spray with this scent? Please, thank you, because it smells so good. So yeah, I'll do the same sort of thing that I did with the tanning water. Again, I've moisturized my armpits, all of the above. And I'll just show you guys how I kind of do my hands. So what I do when I'm not using the spray is I just take a little bit of the excess on the mitt and lightly glide over my fingers like that. And I make sure that I do it with my hands straight because again, I don't want any tan to go in the creases of my fingers. That's when you get the really obvious telltale signs. And I go a little bit down onto my palm as well. I wash my hands in a minute as well though, but I do this just so it kind of goes far enough down to my hands. It's not like it suddenly ends at my wrist and then I've got white hands. I try to make it go down a little bit further, and having the moisturizer or hand cream makes it glide on a lot easier. You can kind of see when there's like a nice little gradient. And when it comes to my back, it's gonna be a little bit difficult to show you because obviously I've got my bikini top on. I'm quite flexible. And like, I'm just trying to like miss my bikini strap. I can kind of get my arm right up there, but you can also get tanning mitts that are just quite long and you can just like, and they work quite well, but I just find that I've got quite long arms and quite a short body, so I can just, I don't know, I can just reach everything. So then obviously I'll do the rest of my body, and then once again I will go back in with the spray, literally just to keep everything topped up. And I do also just go like around my neck. So then yeah, once I've done the rest of my body, I will either wash my hands or I'll just take a wipe or something, and I just make sure that I go in between my fingers and almost just like lightly pat over the top, because again, like I've got the moisturizer on, it's not really gonna sink into my hands too much. I find this is one of those sort of trial and error things. You might find that you get a lot more dryness around your wrists, or you might find you get dryness like around your knuckles. It's just something, again, that will kind of vary from person to person, but I just find for me, I just tend to kind of just take off the excess a little bit. Give my hands a little wash with soap, just a very, very quick one, and then it just kind of gives me enough color on my hands, but not to the point where it just looks like, damn, she's been fake tanning. So yeah, I'm now gonna finish off the rest of my body and then I'll leave this on for the next 3 hours or so. I'm gonna go chill in my big bag of clothes. Normally I like to wear, when it's not summer, I like to wear a onesie. I just find I've got like all the movement and it's like I'm just cooking within my onesie. But I'm not going to do that right now because it's boiling. But yeah, I'm going to finish up and then I'll show you guys in around about 3 hours and I'll show you the finished look. Tan, development. I'll show you how it looks in a couple of hours. Okay, I'm back. So it's actually only been a couple of hours. I was planning on leaving this on for about 3 hours, but I only left it on for two just because I had to head out in a minute. It's just such a nice natural tan. Like, this is the sort of color I go in the actual sun. So this is it completely washed off after just a couple of hours. One thing I will say, one other little tip, is if you want your tan to last a little bit longer and if you want your guide color to kind of stay on a little bit longer as well, I know how sad it is. It's like, get the tiny little violin out when you shower and you just watch all of your guide color just go down the drain and it's like, all my hard work is gone. Why am I talking to the non-existent drain on the floor again? But if you've got the balls, because I know I hate cold showers, try doing it as cool as you can and you'll find that actually the guide color will wear off a lot more slowly. I don't know, I've just found that's always worked for me. So yeah, if you want your tan to last an extra day or two, or just if you want to keep a little bit more of the guide color, shower a little bit more cool, because the hot water will kind of just break it down a little bit quicker. Fun fact. So then I'll quickly mention a couple of other products that I'm not going to be using today, but I will just share with you guys because these are also really good. So the Gentle Glow DHA Free Milk is really good for all my sensitive skin friends out there, or maybe you just don't like standard fake tan that has DHA in it. So like I said, this is DHA free, it's also fragrance free and oil free, and it's just really good, like I said, if you have sensitive skin or if you're a little bit more fair and you just want something that'll give you a bit of a natural glow, this will work after 2 or 3 days. We've then got the Yutan Total Glow, which again is DHA free, so again, good if you've got sensitive skin. This is really good when you're actually out in the sun because it actually has a tan accelerator in it. So yeah, I'm very interested in this one. Obviously, you can apply it over your SPF, which I highly, highely recommend. Wear your SPF. But yeah, this can also help to accelerate your tan a little bit. Then one of the last products I'm going to be mentioning is the Exfoliating Tan Milk, which is really, really good to help prolong your tan. So this actually also contains 1% salicylic acid, which if you don't know, it helps to unclog your pores. It can help to clear up your skin a little bit and even it out. So again, if you find that you tend to suffer with clogged pores or blemishes or whatever from tanning, this is really, really good at sorting that out. The main reason I like this stuff though is we've all been there, the tiger bread tan. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I will insert a picture of said tiger bread tan, or just a tiger bread, yum, carbs. This basically stops any tiger bread scenarios happening, which I know a lot of you guys know what I'm talking about here. You'll have your tan, it'll look amazing for a couple of days, and then you might find it starts to wear off and you get like the tiger breadness on your arms or on your chest or something. This, because it exfoliates your skin really, really gently, it helps get rid of that completely. I don't think I actually mentioned as well, this is actually a gradual tanner, so this is developed over 6 to 8 hours. And it smells like coconut, it smells so good. So I'm gonna do a look on the back of my hand to show you. You can see it's just a colorless fake tan. And yeah, I will just apply it to my body with my hands and it just feels really nice. It's really hydrating as well. So yeah, I'll normally use that around about my 4th or 5th day into tanning, just to kind of give it a little bit of sun and something, just to add a little bit more glow, even everything out a little bit more. To be honest, even without the exfoliating tan milk, my tan will normally last on my skin for around about a week or so, and then it will start to fade really gradually, but this just helps to kind of give it a little bit more longevity, evens everything out a little bit, it gives it like a gentle exfoliation without having to like fully exfoliate, and then you end up maybe over exfoliating. This just kind of does it, so everything just remains smooth. To be honest, even without the exfoliating tan milk, my tan will probably last on my skin for around about a week or so before I feel like I need to top it up a little bit more. So then I'll just kind of repeat the whole process like I've shown you guys, like the scrubbing, the moisturizing, the no shaving. I mean, I never said this was like a lazy girl's guide to tanning, but it's a foolproof way. And by the way, can we talk about my hands? The little hand trick that I showed you earlier. There's no crustiness, nothing. My hands aren't orange, nothing's like caught in between. Just doing like jazz hands at this point. But yeah, the hand trick, that really helps. Because I feel like most people can put on a tan, but it's like the elbows, the knees, the hands and feet are the worst ones. And yeah, I never get that because I do all of this. Anyway guys, I really hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully I gave you a couple of tips and tricks on how to get a nice little flawless looking tan. The jazz hands have come back again, but honestly like this situation here, foolproof. As always, any links and discount codes and stuff for the products I use today will be down below, so make sure you check that out. Once again, thank you to Yutan for sponsoring this video. Honestly, their tanning products are bomb. I've been using them for years. I never really end my videos while I'm stood half naked in my bathroom, so it feels a little bit weird doing the outro like this, but If you guys enjoy this video or if you find it helpful, as always, please do give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you do want to see more of me because I upload all the damn time. But apart from that is it from me. I love you guys and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.